Good morning, students. Welcome to the class of HTML. In the previous lecture, we have discussed that how to design a form by using different form elements like input element, type element, text box, password, radio button, checkbox, drop down list, submit button, reset button, text area and field set. Now, today we will discuss the page number 29 and we will discuss the introduction to frames, frame set and frame. Now, students, come to the book. We are having topic frames. Students, at our homes, we are having different photo frames in which we are displaying the photograph of our family. Some photograph has a space to display only one photo. Some are like the collage form in which two, three photographs we can display, some in the horizontal wise, some vertical, or some in big size, some in the small size. According to our wish, we are purchasing our photo frames. In the same way, in the HTML, we have facility to set our frames. What are the frames? It means that whenever we need to display our web pages, multiple web pages on a single screen, then we can set them in frames. Clear? So, the term of frame is frames enable to display more than one web page on the screen. I already discussed with you. Means that whenever we need to display more than one web page on one screen, then we are using this frames. For that, we are having some elements of the frames. First is frame set. What is frame set? This element defines the rows and columns in the frame. Means whatever the area is occupied by the web page on the screen, we decide its proportion with the help of this frame set in the terms of rows and columns. Let's suppose I want my photograph horizontally or vertically. I want 20% row wise, 40% column wise. That I will decide with the term that is frame set. And its syntax is frame set, and we will write that how many percentage of row or column or only row or only column we will decide, that we will write over here, and at the end we will close it. Now, second term we are having, that is frame. What is the term of frame? This element specify a document that is to be displayed in the frame. Means with the frame set we decide the area on the screen, and with the attribute frame we decide that which web page will come in a particular frame set. Clear? For that we are having syntax that is frame, and we will write the source of it like we have done in the image src. We have done with the hyperlink. In the same way, with the frame attribute, we will give the source and we will type the path, and at the end, we will close it. Now, my practical will make you more clear. We have some web pages already designed in the last lectures. Now, open the notepad to discuss about the frames. Now, see, if I'll do now, students, one point you should note that for deciding the frame set, we don't need to give the body tag. With the body tag, we can't show the output of the frames. Already web pages are designed. We have to only adjust them on our screen. That's why we are not using this frame set for body. Now, see what we'll do. We will write frame set without space. Rows means I want to display my web page row wise. That is my choice. Then let's suppose I have written 20% and 80%. We have to make the proportion in 100% so that the area is occupied correctly. The percentage is my choice, 20-80, 30-70 or whatever. Next, we will use the second element, that is frame. SRC means source. And let's suppose I want to copy the address of my this web page. I'll select the address. I'll copy it. That web page is already made. Now come to your that notepad in which we are doing the coding of the frames. In front of image SRC, we will do double quotes, control V, double quotes close, angular bracket close. Now, firstly, we will see the output of it. See, my first web page 20% height and this 80% means this area is occupied fully by my this first web page. Now, come to your notepad where we are doing the codings. Now, I want to insert my second web page. For that, again, I will write frame set. Let's suppose this time I want column wise is equal to 50%, 50%. Proportion is my choice. Rows and columns is my choice. Now, we will write frame source SRC is equal to double quotes. Again, we will copy the path of second web page. Let's suppose my second web page is this form. I'll select it. Control C to copy the path. I'll close this notepad. I'll come to my original notepad where I am doing the coding. Now see, in that, what we will do? We will paste the second path of the web page, double quotes close, angular bracket close. I saved my work. I'll close my notepad. Now see, my first web page 20 and 80% row wise, this comes column wise 50% and 50%. Means this area is free for me. I can add another one web page over here. For that, what we will do? Again, we will open our notepad and we will write the coding. As many as frame set I want, I can use. Frame set, let's suppose this time I want only rows is equal to 100%. I want only rows 100%. That is my choice. I have given you different combinations. Rows, columns, and now I have taken only rows. Now see, I will write frame set, frame source is equal to double quotes. Again, I will copy the path of my third web page. Let's suppose I want to copy the path of this web page. And what we will do? We will paste the path in our frame set coding notepad. Control V, double quotes close, angular bracket close. Now I'll close it and I will show you the output of it. See, my first web page is coming row wise, second is coming column wise, and this comes 100% area, means fully the remaining area is occupied by this picture. Hope you understand the lecture of using frame set. We can make a collage of our web pages according to our requirement. On the basis of these frame sets, we have given you different project works. Do that project works with the help of school links. Thank you so much.